Salut, bonjour, and welcome back to JustDisc, your informative disc golf channel. Today, we wanted to let you guys know about the two biggest mistakes we often see people make when purchasing a disc. And it's these mistakes that often leads to them losing interest, losing confidence, and in turn, just not using the disc anymore. And no, this has nothing to do with speed or the flight rating system. Now, before we get started, we first just have to thank acerunners.ca for sponsoring this video. Truthfully, they are the best disc golf distributor in Canada with a huge selection of discs, a website that's easy to navigate, and great customer service. Nobody compares when selling disc golf equipment, so check them out at acerunners.ca if you haven't already. Now, without further ado, let's get into it. Understanding the flight numbers, the speed at which you can throw, and having a disc that feels good in your hand are all important factors, and feel is especially important since if it doesn't feel good, it's not going to breed confidence, and we all know that disc golf is a very mental game. However, whenever somebody buys a new disc, I always ask them two very important questions. The first is, what weight did you get the disc in? And the second is, what type of plastic did you choose? Most of the time, they know what type of plastic they got, but they don't understand the reasons why they chose it. And as far as weight goes, I often see them turn the disc over to double check. Fortunately, we have some helpful tips on plastics and weights so that you can make a more informed decision the next time you're looking to pick up a disc. Now, when looking at plastics, different plastics affect the stability of a disc and therefore how it flies. So something like a destroyer in one plastic is going to fly differently than a destroyer in a different plastic. Since so many companies have their own types of plastics, we're going to talk about plastics in their most basic form, base and premium. Base plastics are generally more understable to start, but they also wear out a lot quicker, so over time they become even more understable. On the other hand, premium plastics, especially ones that are less flexible, are more overstable and take longer to bead in and develop that understability. We did a video on base versus premium plastics, so check it out if you want to learn more. So, if you think you're going to have trouble throwing a disc with a high fade or a high speed, get it in a base plastic or don't get it at all. On the other hand, if you think you're going to overpower the disc because of its slow speed as well as its high turn, get it in a premium. It will truly help you out. Now, considering that pretty much every disc golf manufacturer grades their plastics differently, it can get confusing quite quickly, but we highly suggest you check out the Putthead's Disc Golf Plastic Comparison Chart to better understand the durability, stability, and flexibility of the different plastics. So let's now discuss the importance of disc weight. Choosing the right weight for your disc is actually more important than choosing the right type of plastic. And that's because a few grams lighter or a few grams heavier can have a massive impact on how the disc performs. For example, in the past, I used to carry max weight distance drivers, and all it really did was make it more difficult when throwing these discs to get their intended flight. And I therefore couldn't really throw them flat that frequently or even get a bit of turn. But now, over the last few years, anything above a 10 speed, I throw at around 171 grams. And even though it's a few grams different from a max weight distance driver, my distance game has improved substantially. Now, it's important to note that there are times to throw those heavier discs and times to throw those lighter discs. And we already did a video on this, heavier versus lighter discs. So check it out at the end of this video if it's something you're interested in. But professionals, they use a mix of both, so keep that in mind. As a general rule though, especially for newer players, the higher the speed of disc you're looking to get, the lighter the weight you should get it in. And we here at JustDisc believe that for your putters in mid-ranges, you should really try and stay closer to those max weights because they're about accuracy and good stability, not distance. But with your fairway drivers and your distance drivers, get them a little bit lighter. A sweet spot would be 160 to 170 grams for most players, and you're definitely gonna notice a big improvement. And as previously mentioned, even the top tier distance professionals carry lighter discs, so there really is no shame. We got to eliminate that shame of getting lighter discs, and nobody's really gonna know anyways unless they try your disc for themselves. So, the next time you're looking to pick up a new disc, make sure that you're paying attention to its weight and plastic. Sometimes the last disc left on the shelf in an amazing color is there for a specific reason. Either people don't like its weight, or its plastic, or maybe the disc has something wrong with it. Now, we here at JustDisc hope that you feel that much better about purchasing your own disc. And if you like this video and you want more informative quality disc golf content, subscribe if you haven't already to join our incredible disc golf community. And if you want more exclusive content, check out our Patreon and don't forget to check out acerunners.ca for all your disc golf equipment. Thanks as always for watching JustDisc, guys, and we'll see you in the next one. Merci beaucoup et à bientôt.